What's going on, fam? Eric Ellis here with wolvesacademy.com, and in this video we're going to be talking about how to do split testing for your sales funnel landing pages, what steps you want to take, what you should be looking for, how to actually optimize, and how to drastically increase your conversions. So with that being said, let's get right into the content. But before we do, if you guys like videos about affiliate marketing, make sure to go ahead and smash that subscribers button, hit that notifications bell, and join the family. Let's dig in. Fam, Eric Ellis here. So in this video, we're going to do a quick case study for a landing page that I was able to increase by 10%, increase my conversions by 10% simply by switching up the headline. So boom, we're behind the laptop. If you notice, we're in my ClickFunnels back office, and there's two different variations, right? And there's one variable that we are split testing. Now, if we go into the actual landing or the split test, right? How do we actually set up a split test? You're gonna do it internally in ClickFunnels. Now, without actually diving into the data, it shows immediately that this has a 91.21% confidence score. Now, what happens is what the confidence score does is over the course of the lifetime of the actual landing page, is where it actually gathers this data. So what happens is, what can actually be pretty misleading is if you're looking at the actual funnel based off of the day and not the lifespan of the actual funnel. So I'll go ahead and give you guys an example of what I mean, right? So here's the control, here's the variation, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys the actual variable and why it was able to increase 10%. Well, first and foremost, let's actually look at the stats. So if we look at the stats here, this is my the type of funnel this is for an application, right? So they put in their email. Once they put in their email to get access to the VSL or the free training basically is kind of like a webinar, and at the end of the webinar there's a call to action for them to actually fill out an application. Once they fill out the application, they go to the scheduler, they schedule a call, and then we close down sales anywhere from $1,000 plus, right? So with that being said, if we look at today's date, right, the control is 33% and the variation is 42%. So it's the variation is converting at about 9%, right? But we don't want to look at the daily. We want to look at the long term, right? So if we look at August 2nd to August 9th, or Saturday, which is almost about a week, this is strictly free traffic. So if we look at the inner circle, right, we have 202 unique clicks to the control. We have 111 unique clicks to the variation. So how many clicks should you actually have before you decide which variation to choose? I say 100 clicks minimum. Once you have 100 clicks, it'll give you pretty decent amount of data, right? So in this, we actually have 300 clicks, right? But we actually have 100 clicks minimum to each landing page. Now, if we look here, the control is currently, and I actually messed up that, this was about 50%, this was about 39%. But because I've been actually going to this page and not opting in, I've actually messed up the numbers a little bit, but it's okay. But if we look at the control, right, the control is 37%. The variation is 47%. So that's the difference of about 10%, right, which is a big difference. Now, what is the two deciding factors? It's the headline, right? So the first one, this is the control, right? Learn the number one solution to quitting that job you hate, right? And then it says, free video reveals how you can ethically steal my six-figure online business today. And then discover weird new method, how to make a lot of money with very little work. Free video reveals how you can ethically steal my six-figure online business today. Now, if we look here, we have the same subheadline, We have the same call to action on the button, We have the same scarcity below the actual button. We have the same scarcity below the button. And we have the same color scheme. The only difference between these two variations is one variable. And that variable is the headline. So the difference between the control and the actual variation was literally just switching up the headline. So this goes for any niche, right? Now, when it comes to actually split testing, there's different variations we could be, or it's not variations. Yes, different variations, but also different variables. So how many different variables can we split test on this actual landing page, right? The first variable is the headline. The second variable is the subheadline. The third variable is the call to action. The fourth variable is the scarcity. And the fifth variable is the actual color scheme. So if I were to switch up the button, maybe the background on the page, so on and so forth, right? So five different variables. Now, whenever you're split testing, you never want to go ahead and do multiple variables, meaning I'm not going to go ahead and split test the headline and then on this page have a different headline and a different call to action button, because I do not know which variable is responsible for the increase in conversions. Meaning, I don't know if it was the headline or if it was the color scheme. I don't know if it was the headline or the call to action button. So whenever you're split testing, make sure you're split testing one variable. In this case, I'm split testing the actual headline. Now, what can we do, right? What I can do is I'm gonna go ahead and actually declare, it's clearly the actual winner here. So I'm gonna declare this as the winner, right? I'm gonna declare this as the winner. And then the next step is actually creating a different variation, right? So I'll go ahead and click this green button, create a different variation. And then the next thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and actually split test a variable. So what I personally like to do is this is the headline. This headline did better. This is the winner. So we completely are leaving this one in the past. Now, what I want to do is, right, I'm going to go ahead and actually continue to try to beat this headline. If you're at least within 40 to 60% conversions on your landing page with cold and warm traffic, which is pretty good, and you can't beat your headline, meaning if you try it 3 to 5 times, 3 to 5 different variations testing one variable, the variable that we're testing is the headline. If I cannot beat that actual variation, the next step that I'm gonna do is, okay, cool, this is the winning variable, which is the headline. So on the next variation, I'm gonna go and keep the same headline. The next variation that I'm gonna be split testing is the actual subheadline. Variable. Yeah, so I'm gonna be split testing a different variable now. Two different variations, same headline. We're just gonna be switching up the actual subheadlines, right? Which is an additional variable. Then after I can't beat that one, then I'm gonna go down to the actual call to action. So instead of yes, get instant access, I might say yes, steal my copy. Yes, show me how, I want in. Different variables, right? I'm not switching up everything on the page. I'm specifically split testing the variable, which is the actual call to action button. And then if I can't beat that, if I get to a point, and your conversions are gonna continue to increase as I start split testing these different variables, one variable each, headline, subheadline, button color, so on and so forth. Two different variations, we're split testing one variable. And then after I can't beat it, as long as you're profitable, right, then I'll start from the beginning. Then eventually the whole goal is to continue to optimize until you get to your target audience and you're sending target traffic to your specific target audience, if you can't beat the actual landing page, boom, you leave it, and then you go to the next step in the actual funnel. So with that being said, my friend, that is how you go ahead and split test different landing pages in your affiliate marketing business. Now, if you like this video, go ahead and smash that subscribers button, hit the notifications bell to join the family for future heat. Make sure to hit that like button, like smash it, punch it in the freaking face, because it really does help. And if you guys want to know my number one recommendation to make money online, if you're tired of struggling in affiliate marketing, if you're tired of not getting results, if you're tired of not being able to convert people into sales, if you're tired of just working a job and you want to fast track to actually getting results within your affiliate marketing business, there's going to be a free training that I created down below. You click the first link in the description or the link down below or the button down below, wherever, right? Click it, get access to that training, and you will also potentially have the opportunity to work with myself and my team, so that way we can expedite your success process, help you be successful, and get you on the fast track to success, so that way you can quit that job you hate, live a life of abundance, and be your own boss. Click down below, and I can't wait to see you on the other side. First and foremost, I want to say thank you for watching this video. If you like this video and want me to make more like it, make sure to smash that like button. Also, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to join the fam and click that notifications bell to be notified every time I drop some new heat. Lastly, if you're tired of working a job, if you want to freaking fire that boss, live life on your terms, and never have to work a 9-to-5 ever again, click the first link in the description to learn the best way to make money online right now. Until next time, Eric Ellis, the Wolf of Marketing, checking out.